The first step is determining the dimensions of the front of the card. So I'm using an example for this. If you have an example card, you can measure your card and use those dimensions. It's also a good idea to check that you have an envelope that's going to be the right size. So you can take an envelope and take the size and make sure it's a little bit smaller just so that the card can fit. You'll want a little bit of extra size on each side of the card. Okay, so I'm using this card as an example. So the front of my card is about 4 1/4 inches by 5 1/2. But we're actually going to need to double this dimension, making this 8 1/2 inches tall. Yep, so from here to the top is 8 1/2 inches tall because we're going to need the full size of what will end up being cut out after we print it. So I'm just gonna jot that down. My dimensions were 8 1/2 inches by 5 1/2 inches. You're probably going to end up printing your piece on a full-size piece of paper. If you're in the US, you'll probably use 8 1/2 by 11. I'll talk about that later, but for now, all you need is the actual size of the card. Then we can go into Procreate to create our canvas. To create a new canvas in Procreate, in your gallery view, tap the plus in the top right corner. We're creating a custom dimension for this project, so tap on this little icon in the top right to create a custom size. The first tab is your dimensions. Now, the first thing I recommend doing is here at the bottom, change your dimensions from pixels to inches, unless you want to use centimeters or millimeters. I'm using inches. Then we want to enter the width and the height. So my width was 5.5 and my height is 8.5. Make sure that the DPI says 300. DPI stands for dots per inch, and having a higher number will produce a higher quality result when you go to print it. Depending on what your goals are for this project, you may need to change your color profile. If you are just printing this at home on your home computer, and especially if you're not using tons of colors in the project, you can leave the color profile to the default, which is RGB. Typically, RGB is used for displaying artwork on screens because of the way the color is displayed using light. A lot of professional printers use CMYK. That stands for cyan, magenta, yellow, and key or black, and that corresponds to the ink cartridges in a printer. So if you do intend to get this printed at a print shop, they'll probably require CMYK. And if you want to use tons of bright colors, then choosing CMYK will make it so that your artwork on screen looks more closely to what it will look like on paper. I'm gonna stick with RGB just because I'm only using black for this project. And even if I did want to use colors, my printer is pretty good at being able to interpret the RGB. Okay, and then lastly, under Canvas Properties, if you want, you can name this to, let's say, greeting card, or maybe you can even put the exact dimensions if you'd like. Just tap on Untitled Canvas and change the name and then choose Create. So next time you want to create a canvas with this dimension, you can tap the plus and then scroll down to the bottom, and then you'll see the greeting card, which we just created. Okay, so let's go back into this piece, and now we can create our artwork. Something important to remember is that on your card, your design should be on the bottom half if you're printing it like, or if you're gonna be folding it like this. If you want to have your card open this way, then it'll need to be on the right side and you can flip your canvas like that. For this example, I'm going to stay in this orientation and keep my artwork in the bottom half so that it prints on the front of the card. I'm also only going to be making artwork on the front of the card, but you could make it on the back as well. After you print it, you'll just fold it in half. To make sure that I'm staying in the bottom half, I'm going to turn on my drawing guides by going to Actions, Canvas, and then toggling on the drawing guide right there. You'll see a grid appear. To make it so it just splits it in half, I'm going to go to Edit Drawing Guide. At the top here, I can change the color of the guide. Maybe I'll make it black, just so I can see it a little bit better. And then the grid size, I'm going to increase all the way to max so that it just is splitting it in half like this. Okay, and then choose Done. So now I know that I want to focus my artwork on the bottom half below this line. So at this point, you can create your design. Remember that if you choose a ton of colors, then when you print it, you're going to have to use a lot of ink. For this design, I'm going to stick to using black and make it pretty simple. So after I finish my design, I will check back in with you on how to finish up preparing this to print. All right, so I'm done with this fairly simple design. If you want, you can reposition it so that it is centered on your page and also centered in the middle of this bottom half of your card. So I would recommend making a copy of this canvas because the next thing we're going to do, it's a little bit hard to revert this back to this size. So just in case you ever wanted to come back to this original design, what I'm going to do is go back to my gallery. And then this canvas that I just created, I'm going to make a copy of it. I'm going to duplicate it by sliding it to the left here and choosing duplicate. Okay, so that's just a copy, and then I'll choose this first one. Okay, for this step, we're going to be increasing the size of the canvas so that it matches the size of your piece of paper, just so that when you go to print it, you know that it's going to be the right dimensions. So there's a lot of kind of weird things that we're going to do here, but just follow along and it will make sense. So the very first thing I'm going to do is create a new layer and drag it down to the bottom of my layers stack. And then I'm going to fill this layer with white. An easy way to get white is to just tap and hold your finger on the screen on the background. If your background is already white, then you can choose white here and then fill this layer with white. This will make more sense in a few minutes. Okay, and then I'm going to turn off the drawing guide by just going to Actions, Canvas, and toggling off drawing guide so that that cross in the middle goes away. The next step is increasing the size of our canvas to match the size of the piece of paper. To do this, go to your Actions and choose Canvas, then choose Crop and Resize. Right now, mine says 5.5 inches by 8.5. That's exactly the size of the card as it will be printed out. But I'm printing mine on 8.5 by 11 size paper. So I'm going to choose, my 8.5 is actually already correct. I'm going to change my 5.5 to 11 and then choose done. Okay. The next thing is I'm going to open my layers and uncheck the background color. So this is showing me what it's going to look like when I go to print this piece, okay? So just for reference, it's if I have my piece of paper here of where I'm printing it, then I know I'm going to just be printing it on this half of the paper because that's the size of my card. Okay, so I'll end up needing to cut the paper in half to make it so that it's the right size for my card. I like to turn the background color off just to give me a better visual of what this will actually look like when I print it. For me, because of the size of my card, it's going to be really easy to know where to cut my paper. I'll only have to make one cut down the middle. I'm gonna change this up though, just in case you are having a little bit more of a situation like this, where the size of your card isn't exactly the size of your piece of paper, to give you some tips on how you'll know where to cut your paper after you print it, okay? So here's something you can do. You can create guides for yourself on where to print. At the top of my layers menu, I'm gonna add a new layer and change my color to black, okay? And then now, wherever the corner of my card ends, I'm just going to draw a straight line up, so it's kind of like following this line up, and then another straight line this way. And you can go all the way to the edge of the paper if you want to just, whoops, trace the whole top of the card like this. Remember, if you draw a line and hold it, then it turns into a straight line. So I'm just going to basically outline the whole card with black because this is going to be where I will end up cutting it. Okay, I'm gonna move this layer down below that white layer just because that's kind of denoting where the edge of my paper is. And then also, because this is just going to be a guide for me where to cut it, I could have used a really light gray instead of black, or I can just reduce the opacity of this layer. So the reason for this is because when you actually print it, the background color will be white. It won't be transparent like this. You'll just be printing it on paper. So if you didn't have these guides, you would have no idea where to cut it. So putting these guides and making them outside of the bounds of your actual card will tell you where to cut it. I probably could have made mine a lot thinner and less noticeable, but anyway, you get the point. Okay, so now we are ready to export this and then print it. So if you have, there's a couple different ways that you can do this. I will show you a way to do it to print directly from your iPad to your printer without having to do it through your computer, but I know that you may not have that option. So if you have a printer that is enabled to print wirelessly, then you can follow this method. Go to Actions and then Share. Under Share Image, find PDF. And then I always choose Best Quality. It's going to give you some export options. As I scroll down here, I can see there's a bunch of different options here, and I see Print as an option. So you should see that. If you don't, you can click Edit Actions and choose Print. Okay, so I'm going to choose Print. So it will give you a preview of what you're going to be printing. Select the printer you'd like to use. If you want more than one copy, you can. And then other options here. I'm just going to leave all the defaults and then choose Print. And then it's going to start printing. I'll show you what it looks like. If you don't have a printer that can connect to your iPad, you can save this file as a PDF the same way by going to Share, Share Image as PDF. Choose Best, and then instead of choosing Print from this menu, you will need to send this PDF to your computer. You can do this a couple different ways. You can use AirDrop if you have a Mac. You can use email, email yourself the PDF, save it to Dropbox, and then open it on your computer that way. So you're gonna know what works best for you. But just send this PDF to your computer, and then from your computer, you can open the PDF and then print it like you normally would. Just make sure in the print preview of your computer that it looks how you're expecting it to look. So in this case, this is exactly how I would expect. If for some reason it's really small or really zoomed in, you may need to check your printer options and scale it that way, okay? And then once you print it, I'll show you what it will look like. So I've just printed this piece. Now, this is what it's going to look like at first. You'll have your design, and then you can kind of see those guides that we drew. So just to go over it in pencil so you might be able to see a little bit better. You can see the guides that we did that will help us figure out where to cut this out. So if you have a paper cutter, you can bring this over there and then cut it down to size. And this is what I did with this pink piece. Then all you do is fold it in half like this, and you're ready to give it to someone. Another little fun tip you can do is take some other supplies that you use for lettering. Like I'm going to use this white gel pen and do some extra accents on top. So it's kind of like combining your digital calligraphy with something handmade. And then you can write your greeting inside and hand off a perfectly handmade gift. Now, just a reminder, I did print this on pink paper. If I were to change the background of my piece in Procreate to this light pink and then print it like that, I would use a ton of ink. So that's fine. If you don't have colored paper, you can do it that way. But it is a fun idea to print it on colored paper, and then anything that would be white on your screen is going to show up as the color of your piece of paper. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to turn your Procreate artwork into a real greeting card.